Welcome to another Shopify tutorial. Today, we're going to show you how to connect Google Analytics to your Shopify store. Once you log into your Shopify, in your admin, you want to click on Online Store and then go down to Preferences. Inside of here, you'll see Google Analytics, the second section. And honestly, if you want a full written description on how to do this, you can click on how do I set this up? And that will actually answer a lot of questions if you have any to set this up. But I'm still gonna walk you through this. And the first thing we wanna do is obviously create a Google Analytics account. To do that, you wanna go to analytics.google.com and go through the process of creating one. Because I already have an account, I'm gonna show you how I would do it. So I'm already logged in here to my Google Analytics account. Once I log in, this is what you will see as a dashboard. So in order to add a new website, so anytime you have a new brand new website, you wanna definitely add a new property to your Google Analytics. So it's different data that's being pulled into different accounts. So you wanna go to admin here at the bottom and then create account. So I'm gonna click create account. And then the account name is gonna be Little Bits Treats. And then I'm gonna leave everything checkmarked as far as the recommended. I'm gonna hit next. We do wanna measure the web. We don't have an app, so we're just gonna leave this one checkmarked. Go down here, click next. And then it's gonna ask me for my website name. Again, it's gonna be the same. So Little Bits Treats. And then the website URL, you wanna make sure that you put in your real URL, not the Shopify store URL. So you wanna do www.littlebitstreats.com. And then industry category, you can just select one here. Ours is gonna be food and drink. If you don't find yours, just probably select other, I believe there might be. Yeah, there is other. And then reporting time zone, wanna do our time zone, which is gonna be Chicago. And then create. After this, it's gonna give you the terms of service agreement. You wanna make sure that you read through that and then check mark that and then read through the other one, check mark that one, and then I accept. So once you have all that stuff set up, it will give you, it will go straight to the tracking code. So tracking ID is gonna be that one, and then the global site tag, this is what we'll need in order to put this inside of Shopify. So all we need to do is grab all this right here, and then I'm gonna hit Command C or Control C on a PC to copy this text, and then we go back to our preferences. This is what we wanna paste in here. So we paste that, and we click Save.
Okay, now that you have the Google Analytics set up right here, you do wanna make sure that you check mark the used enhanced e-commerce. I'm gonna check mark that and save that. That's gonna allow us to track a little bit more data than just people landing and visitors and things like that. You can actually be able to track conversions and sales. Now you wanna head back to the Google Analytics and then go to admin. And then right here towards this last column, you'll see e-commerce settings. You click on that. And then you wanna enable this and then enable this. And then you wanna save.
And that's it. After you're done with that, then you can do some testing. I believe with the, may have it here, but ours is not gonna work because our URL, we haven't purchased that yet. So once we actually purchase that and make that live, then we'll be able to track some data. If you wanna make sure that you've installed it correctly, there's something called the Tag Assistant by Google. It's a Chrome extension. You wanna install that. It's kind of like Facebook also has a different one called the Facebook Pixel Helper, I believe. So once you click on that little integration inside of Chrome, you will see whether the Google Analytics tag, it's being fired on that particular website. If it's not being fired and you're testing it with the Google Tag Assistant, then there's something wrong. You either maybe put the incorrect URL or if something got messed up while you were copying and pasting or something of the rather too. But it's a pretty simple, straightforward process. And again, it will give you data in addition to what Shopify already gathers. It will actually give you that data inside of Shopify, inside of Google Analytics, which is super helpful. All right, hopefully that was good for you. We have a bunch of more tutorials on Shopify still coming out. So if you have any questions or any suggestions on what type of video we should create next, leave those comments down below. Make sure you hit that like button and subscribe to our channel to keep watching our videos and not miss any of our new tutorials. All right, see ya.